Hi, I'm Phil Collen from Def Leppard, and for Behind The Riff, I'm going to do Pour Some Sugar On Me off the Hysteria album. This, by the way, just so you know, is a 30th anniversary Jackson that I splash painted for the 30th anniversary, so it's called Splatter. Pretty awesome. 2009, I think I did this. But yeah, so this is what I'm going to be using tonight. So the Pour Some Sugar On Me riff originally came about. We'd finished the album, and Joe Elliott was sitting in a corridor at the studio in Holland, in Hilversum Studios, and he started playing this thing, and Mutt Lang walked past and goes, "What's that?" He goes, "I don't know." He said, "Well, stop a minute, play something." And within probably a half an hour, it was the meat and potatoes of Pour Some Sugar On Me. It kind of had a hip-hop vocal meter. You know, "Love is like a bomb, baby, come and get it on. Love is like a..." That kind of thing. So we created a track around that. And I come up with this riff. And initially it was in a different key, and the riff was more like... It was like, that was more continuous. Mutt said, "Put gaps in it." So it's like... So you hear the snare. We changed the key, so I had to change where I actually played it, which is, instead of doing that open string, I had to play a... And that was the riff, and we had this big gap for the snare to come in, so it was like... So it had this kind of space, so the vocal would work, and like I said, it was almost like a hip-hop meter, the vocal, or rap as it was called back then. This is in the 80s, so the vocal just fit so well over the top of that. It was kind of a speedy, rappy kind of vocal, and we had this massive guitar riff and this drums poking through. It became our biggest hit. The album came out, it didn't do that great initially. That was like the fourth single, and it just exploded after. The album went to number one, kind of all over the world and everything, and that was really the song that did it. There's another part to the song that I'll tell you, because while we're here, and it was kind of like a country riff. Mutt Lang said it should kind of start like this. And he played it with his fingers like that. And I couldn't even do that back then. But I used metal guitar picks. This one's brass. Back then I was using a stainless steel. So I just done that riff more like a... Like... And you can hear the presence and the clicking of a metal pick. It had a kind of an aggression, almost like a violence to it that just sounds really cool when you play rock music. And this is what it sounds like now. So we turned that country riff into more of a lead electric style thing, and ended up like that. So they're the two basic parts in Sugar that everyone remembers. And that was the story behind the riff.